Welcome to my YouTube channel on engineer mechanics with illustrations. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates. Let me start with resolution. Okay, resolution of a force. So resolution of force F cos theta and F sine theta will be the force, right? And you can see the formulas here. So we will consider the same problem and we can solve. So we just need to put this actually, in any program, we need to, understand the computer, understand the problem first. So you need to input some values. Okay. That's nothing but force F and the angle theta. Okay. So those are the things which we need to input. So for which you need to, you'll have to enter the value and it has to, take it, receive the forces, right? So the structure of the program, we know that this is the structure of the program. It should be, let's say any program for that matter. So I'll just open the resolve resolution. If you open the project, so I'll not get into the graphics part, okay, initially. Now what I'll do, I'll just explain the simple part, simple thing. So what we need to do, we need to enter the number of forces. So the things which you need to include for that. So standard input output dot h, these are the header files which we need to include, okay, libraries, and include math dot h, because we need to calculate certain things, okay, sine theta, cos theta and all we need to make use. So we'll be using this math.h and the graphics.h. As I've already told you, I'll be using C graphics for drawing those pictures, okay, those forces and the arrow marks, fx and other things, right? And include this conio.h, that is for get ch and all, okay, those functions will be there in this conio.h, okay. And int main, so this is the actual structure of the this thing, int main, and within that main you will be calculating everything, okay. And so you need to define the variables, okay. These are the integer type of variables. The number of forces, n is the number of forces, okay, and I is the count counter, okay. It will count whenever there is a for loop, okay. So simply, actually, what you can do, you can, I have a simple program which where you will get, the resolved forces. I'll just open that. Okay. So that this graphics and all will not be there. Right. So it will be easy for you to understand as well. Okay. So this is the simple program. I'll just close the other one. We will open that. So in this main, close this one first. I'll open this one, so which is having simple program. So you can see very simple program, and if I execute, it will give you only whatever without graphics this will execute. Let us see. Okay. So what is this happening in this one? We need to define. I'm just considering this f fraction value, okay, because force can be fraction, fx can be fraction, fy can be fraction, and theta value will be there, okay. So that I am defining. So here actually I have included only stdio.h, math.h, and I can. So this is the command. The syntax to define the value of pi value, okay. So pi value. Can be defined by this way, okay. So you can whenever required you can call that function and calculate the value. This is required to convert, because this this computer program or computer will not take the angle in degrees initially, so it will take it in radians, okay. So you need to convert that into degrees and radians, vice versa, whenever necessary, okay. So first define the variables, because we will have to calculate. So if you can see this, f will be given, fx and fy has to be calculated. So all of them, and theta will be there. There are four variables which I have defined. Okay. So f, fx, fy, theta. And then what you should do is actually you should ask for first initially you should ask for f value. So you can call for printf statement. Okay, so printf enter the force to be resolved. I'll just say resolved. Okay, resolved in newtons. And so enter the force to be resolved in newtons. And new line, it will go to the new line. And you can double quote, you can use double inverted comma and enter that. So next, it has to scan that value of f. Okay, this is only it will print the value. And in order to the computer to take that value, you need to scan that. You know, this is simple C programming. That is input statement. Okay, these are the input statement. And this is printf is an output statement. This scanf is an input. Printf is output and scanf is input. It will take the value, right? So similarly, printf enter the angle. So you need to enter initially force f and angle theta. And then the program has to calculate fx and fy. This is very, very simple program. That's nothing but resolution of the forces, okay? And then, therefore, now printf enter the angle at which the force is acting with respect to horizontal in degrees. You can ask for that. And again, scanf, percentage f, comma, ampersand, theta, because theta is another one defined, we have defined, and it has to end with semicolon. Okay, all the, you know, each line should end with semicolon for in the program. Okay, so then fx is equal to f cos. Okay, because we have included math, automatically cos function will be included. Okay, cos angle theta. Okay. And that value we will be entering in the degrees. Okay, see, we'll be asking in the value in degrees, so it has to be converted to radians. So in order to convert that, degrees into pi by 180. Okay, so pi by 180, if you do it, so degrees will be converted to radians and you will get the actual value. So otherwise you will not get actual value. Then fy is equal to f sine theta. So f sine theta, theta can be converted to radians. Just convert it and just calculate. So this will calculate, these two lines will calculate the value of fx and fy, but it has to be printed onto the output screen, right? It has to return the value. So for that, printf, the horizontal component of the force f, that's nothing but, you can also include fx is equal to, okay? And then horizontal component, the vertical component of the force f is fy, which is equal to, okay, so percentage of newtons comma fx. So this is how you can call the stored value from the computer memory onto the screen. Okay, and then again printf, the vertical component of the force f is fy, which is equal to percentage of newtons. You have to call the the answer saved in fy, so that has to be saved here. And that will be the end of the program. And let us run the program. So run and debug. So it will ask in the beginning, enter the force to be resolved in Newton. Okay, you can just say any value you can enter, 700, 800, whatever, in Newtons. Okay, and the angle of force in degrees. So you can enter any value, let's say 70 degree. If you enter 70 degree, it will be in first quadrant. If you are entering 150 degree, it will be in the second quadrant. If you are entering if you are entering the value equal to 200 and something, 230 or something like that, that will be in the third quadrant. So that way, you will have to enter the angles. Okay. Next, so just enter, and you can see you can get the value. The horizontal component of the force Fx is equal to 239 point something. And vertical component force F is equal to Fy, which is equal to 657.75. Okay, this is how you will get the answer. Okay, any doubt, anybody? Let me just unmute everyone that if you have any question, you can ask me.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Yeah, unmute. Anybody, any doubt? Press enter, it will exit.
Nobody.
All of you are aware of this simple program, right? I think we have just only
printf
scanf. calculate. This is very, very simple program, and is how you can make use of C programming for engineering mechanics. Any doubt here?
Yes, sir.
So let me, okay, let us take that numerical problems and solve the problem using the program which has I will explain the other project. Close this resultant. Okay, now let us run this program and let me demonstrate actual problems which are there over here. Okay. Yeah. So let me take up this problem, actual problem. Yeah. So we have a problem like here. So the total angle, what is, so the given force is F is equal to 20 kilonewton. The angle they have given it with respect to vertical as 30 degree. So what should be the total angle, anybody? What should be the angle we should enter here? You can unmute yourself and answer to me. Anybody you wanted to answer? So what should be the total angle?
360.
Is it 360? Actually, it starts from here to this 270 plus
70.
30. 300 degree, right? So 220 kilonewton is the force. Okay. Press enter. Next, the angle is 300 degree, right? So 300, press enter. And as you can see, actually the value of the force F is very less, and it is showing just like this. But I had done another program where you will get full screen. Okay, that I will demonstrate later. I have a bit of execution problem. Okay, that will give you the forces as well. I'll show you that even. So what problem I have also, that I'll let you know.
So can we use minus 16?
Yeah, 1 second. So one last correction I just need to do. Which one, I don't know. Let me just close one. I think this is the one. Okay. Okay. Close the project. Open. Yeah, let me run the program. And it'll take a little time. Enter the force to be resolved in Newton. So as usual, we have 20 Newton, 20 you can enter. Okay, and enter the angle at which it is there, 300 degree. Yeah, actually it is showing the value with value as well. And this Newton is going somewhere else. Because I have increased the screen size, that's why it is coming less. Otherwise, you can get that zooming option as well. Okay, I am resolving that problem. Okay, but you can see the values here. So what should be the value? 10 kilonewton is Fx. Okay, the horizontal component is 10 newton. Okay, if it is there in kilonewton, right? Then the vertical component of force F is actually 17.32, and you can see the exact answer, right? Okay, so this is how you can make use of the...
Can we input...
Yeah?
Can we input minus 60 instead of 300?
Angle, right? Yeah, I think you can do it. Yeah, you can get that also. Let us demo, you know, test it. No problem. You will get it. Once again, run the program. Because anyhow, it is a calculation part. So definitely there won't be any problem. So I'll just, for the sake of magnitude, 200 I'll enter. Okay. And magnification purpose. And let us enter how much? 60 degree, right? Minus 60. Okay. So it will also come. You can see you will get the answer, right? So here you will get 200 and... what is the angle? No. We'll have to test for that. Minus 60, I need to, you know, check it out. Okay, it has to come. So that's how you need to test the software and execute, and whatever required, you have to do it. Okay, so that's how you can do it. So we'll solve the next problem here, this problem. Okay. So we can have n number of sessions afterwards. Okay. I'll close this. Yeah, run this again. So that graphics part, whatever is there, don't worry about it now initially. Okay. And if you are thorough with the basics part, writing the program, and then I'll give one more session for C graphics. Okay. So enter the force. What is the force? The amount of force is 200. This software now, as of now, this actually program can only take the forces which are going away from the point. So whatever force you enter like this, I mean, if you enter to 200, it will take it as outside. So this is simple program which I have written to calculate the forces, I mean resolve the force which is going away, but there won't be any problem. So you just enter the negative value of the force, so automatically the forces you will get it. Okay. So I just need to try, okay, whether it will work or not, right? So enter the force in Newton, so minus 200. Okay. And so the angle in degree is, so what I should do is here I'll have to consider only, this as the horizontal, and I should enter. So if you want particularly the problem to be considered inclined, so you'll have to, write a program for that. So it will become more general. So now I'll enter 30 degree only. Angle is equal to 30 degree. And as you can see, it is working actually. Some part is working. I'll use some other program where here I need to test little more. So what I'll do, I'll open the other program. Open it. Now this usual one. So where the values are not actually still put on the screen. So minus 200, minus 200. And the angle at which it is acting is 30 degree. Yeah, it's working. Okay. But thing is, you will not be, it will not be taken like this. Okay. So it the one and the same, right? We know that principle of law of transmissibility. So either the force is acting here. Yeah. Either the force is acting here or going away. So the value will remain same. So definitely it will work for the value purpose, but it will not work in the graphics part. So if you want it to be updated with that as well, so we need to change a little program. Update the program. Okay, so it's working, and let us see the values. Okay, the output screen, right? The values are minus 100. Okay, minus that means actually here it is not here I've not mentioned the sign. Actually speaking, it is negative only. Minus 100 Fy is 173 because it is acting downward. So the program is giving answer correctly with the sign as well, and it won't be the computer, if you are written the program properly at once, so it won't do any mistake, but we do mistakes like this. Okay, actually it is understood that it is fx is left, and that's the reason why negative should be there, but we are human beings, we may forget the sign of the forces. But the computer program will not do any mistake if the program is correct. Okay. So that is the advantage of writing the programs. Okay. And you can solve any number of problems within a click of buttons like that. Okay. Just like that. So now this is how you can do it. So now what I'll do, let us move on to the next program. Okay. Next program. And let me close this. So any doubt, anybody?
No, sir.
Yeah, that is what we did. Next, we'll open the resultant force. Okay. Resultant of the force. I have final. I can tell you this program can solve any number of forces. Okay. Program for any number of forces. Like, you know, it can be 1000 number of forces as well. So just need to enter, it will take time for inputting the values, okay? Just keep, you will need to keep doing 1000 forces, entering the 1000 forces and 1000 angles. Just click of a button, you'll be getting the answer, okay? So to demonstrate that, let me just, you know, take up this example where we have four forces, okay? The code as usual, so what is the code we need to generate, all of you? So first thing is we need to input the values, right? So that means it has to ask, you know, the program has to ask how many number of forces are there, okay, initially. Based on that, so that many times it has to print the statements, enter the value, the next force, number force. See, I have made it very automatic. This it will ask for it will roll for the next force, okay? So that you can keep on entering based on the number of forces you input initially. So it will ask for that many number of force values and that many number of angle values. That way I have written the program. I'll just show you simple way. So intmin as usual, here math.h, graphics.h, conio.h and pi value I've defined. So what are the things which I've defined here? Okay, input parameter, the variables, okay? N and I for for loop and other thing, you can use I. Okay, and then sum of x. So here, let me just take up what is the thing we will be going to do in the composition of forces. What we do initially, actually speaking, in the composition, you will have a sigma fx. You will calculate sigma fx value and sigma fy value, and then r is equal to root of sigma fx square plus sigma fy square, and alpha is equal to tan inverse of sigma fy divided by sigma fx. Okay, these are the formulas which you have which already you know, okay, how these will be the, obtained. Okay, so I need to first ask for the forces. It has to scan all those values, so for which I have used for loop. Okay, printf, enter the number of forces. After you enter, so it will scan for the number of forces. Okay, then I have defined the array of forces. Okay, so this is actually called array. So f of n minus 1. So because each and every time you enter, that force has to be saved in this array, f1, f2, f3, f4, f5, something like that. Okay. And similarly, how many f forces you have, so that many fx components will be there, and that many fy components will be there, and there will be theta values, that many theta values will be there. Okay. So what I'll be doing here is, based on the number of values, number of forces you enter, or in the person enters, so that many times it will call for this thing, okay? Enter the value of force number one, okay? If the value, if the first cycle, if it starts, it'll ask for number one, okay? Enter the value of force number one in newtons, enter the value of angle number one in degrees, okay? So after the first cycle is executed, so it will calculate actually sum of sum of fx, okay, sum fx, that's nothing but sigma fx. So in each cycle it will calculate sigma fx, right? So first cycle sigma fx is equal to first f1 cos theta 1 plus f1 cos theta 2, f1 cos theta 1 sigma fx, okay? So similarly sigma fy will be equal to f1 sin theta 1, okay? So that way first cycle will be over. So it will take f of x first one, FFY first one, it will take it, and then it will go out. Okay, I have 10 more minutes. Okay, I'll just yeah, it will go out and it will calculate out whatever is required. What I'll do is I'll share this program because I cannot explain everything. Okay, so I'll be sharing this. Okay. Also, if there are any doubts, I'll let you know. Okay. Afterwards, I can take one more class and I can explain. And that's how it has many number of courses you have entered. So that many cycles it will ask for the values and it will complete that cycle. Okay. After completing the cycle, it will go for the next loop. What is that? Our next main. Okay. So which is nothing but the forces you have entered are listed below. It will give you all the forces which you have entered. That will that will be for confirming whether the forces whatever you entered are correct or not. Okay, so I'll explain all those things, init window and all. This is actually for graphics, C graphics. Okay, C graphics part, this thing, and then OX and OI is for all these things are for C graphics. But what actually necessary is this is the part. Okay, after you enter all the forces, the resultant value will be calculated. You can see here. So as I've already told you, in that first loop, for loop, I've included sigma fx value. And in the second cycle, what actually it will does is, so in the first cycle, it will be sigma fx. Initially, I've defined sigma fx is equal to zero. So in this first cycle, sigma fx is equal to sigma fx plus. That means whatever sigma fx value will be calculated here, it will be added to this zero. So that's how it will be loop will be carried out. Okay, so that way, so at the end of this loop, final whatever value will be there is sigma fx, sum of x. So sigma fx will be there. The last value will be nothing but sigma fx, and the last value of sigma fy will be nothing but total sigma fx. Okay, that's the program. So finally, what you have to show it in the screen is this r value. You have to calculate that r. So therefore, r is equal to square root of sum of fx into fx. So that's nothing but sigma fx square plus sigma fy square. Okay. Then r theta is, theta is equal to, this is actually theta we have defined earlier. So alpha, actually, you can just say this is as alpha. I have just mentioned there is r theta. That's nothing but angle of the r, which is nothing but alpha. So which is nothing but that is tan inverse of a tan theta in C programming. Tan inverse will be called as a tan, okay? Tan inverse of sigma fx, fy by sigma fx into, we need to convert, actually whatever value we'll get, it will be in radians. We'll have to convert it to degrees, okay? 180 by pi. So, and then print the resultant of the given forces is equal to percentage of newtons, and it should print the value of r. And then the angle of resultant with respect to horizontal is equal to percentage of in degrees r theta. This is nothing but the alpha. So that's how the value will be printed. That is what we need. And this program, the remaining part is for drawing those resultant value on screen. Okay, I have just 6 minutes which is left out. What I'll do, I'll just demonstrate using this problem. Okay, let us do the problem here. So just let me run the program. So enter the number of forces. How many forces are there? Four forces. Okay. Four forces. Enter. Enter the value of force number one in Newton. 200. Assume that all of you are able to see the screen. Okay. Next, the angle. Enter the angle 30 degree. Next, second force. Enter the value of force number two in Newtons. 150. Angle is 110 degree. Enter the force number 3. So which is nothing but 750. Enter the value of angle number 3 in degrees. So what should be that? 180 plus 60. 240. And then enter the value of force number 4. That's nothing but 500. And press enter. So enter the value of angle number 4. What is that angle number 4? 360 minus 35. 325. So if just a click of a button that is able to generate the screen, the resultant. Actually, the resultant value is visible here because I have limited the screen value. The screen size I have limited. So that's the reason why This program now, it can work up to the range of total values, range of 250, 300, something like that. So, but the value of resultant, you can, I'll show you here. Yeah, I'll just, yeah, here you can see the resultant force is 712. Okay. And the angle is minus 77 degrees. So you can see here the value resultant. Actually speaking, this is the first time I am executing this problem. I have not tested, but I could get the answer very exactly. You can see 712.74 and alpha is 77.32, and which is correct. And you can see here the resultant is acting this way in the fourth quadrant. And definitely you can, here it's there in the result, fourth quadrant only. You can see here the problem, in the problem, because sigma fx is negative, sigma fx is positive, okay, and sigma fa is negative, so it will be in fourth quadrant, and that is what is happening in for this problem as well. Okay, so that's how you can execute resultant of forces, okay, and write the programs for this. Okay, one more example I'll just demonstrate very quickly with some usual values. Okay, like, you know, to see the graphics part, let's say we'll enter three forces, okay, in the range of 300 and something, 350, and angle is 45 degree, and let's say some 300 newton, and the value of force is, let's say, in the second quadrant we'll assume it as 140 degree, and we'll take the third force in the fourth quadrant, let's say the value is 250 kilonewton, and the angle is, let's say, 345 degree. Okay, just click the button, you can see. So all the three forces, okay, this is in the first quadrant, second quadrant, and the third, fourth quadrant, and the resultant is 456 value. You can get this. Okay, that's how you can get the resultant forces. Okay, and then if you just click here, automatically it will be closed. I mean, you can close. One important thing I just wanted to mention, here is, you can actually make a software as well. So whatever you have, actually whatever you've done is, it has built a software. This Core Black has built a software, and without even this program open, you can run that program. I'll just show you. I'll just close this one. So already that software has been developed. I'll just close this code block. Okay, no programming software is open. So go to that window, wherever that program is, there. Okay, you can see it's saved in my folder. Okay, C programming, and it is there in the last one, and bin, here debug. Yeah, this is the software I was telling about. This is the software which can solve the problem. Okay, resultant forces. So you need not install that code block. You can carry over the software. See, automatically you can get the screen. Okay, the number of forces, let's say two forces I'll enter, those are there in the single in the same quadrant only, first quadrant only, 200, enter, and the degrees 45 are, okay, 30 degree, and let's say another force 400, the angle, let us say 60 degree, and very simply you can see the value, it's there in one window only. Okay, so you can see the value is 581, and this is how you can find out the resultant of the forces using a software which you have built. Okay, so that's how you can build the software. And I can tell you, maybe in future classes I'll give one more demo to do, you know, GUI of that, all that, but now, as of now, this exe file, execution type of files will give you, it's just like a software only. You can, this is not installable, it can be executable, so you can execute portable. Okay, you can just copy this, and I will share you this. Okay, but I will be sharing without this end, okay, without this, what you can call it as, the type of file. Okay, and you can execute and you can run. Okay, thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates.